All those times your mother told you to play outside because playing on the internet is ruining your brain? Well, it turns out she might have been wrong. Sort of. Hello everyone, Amy coming to you on the internet today on DNews, talking about, well, how using the internet might be affecting your brain. And the good news, if you're under 25, your internet and social media habits aren't necessarily damaging. Specifically, we're talking about time spent on social media sites like Facebook. The issue with Facebook, according to some scientists, is that teenagers spending an increasing amount of time on social media sites are stunting their neurologic development. The human brain doesn't reach full maturity until we're in our mid-20s. Before that, during early and mid-adolescence, the human brain undergoes considerable growth and pruning, particularly in the forward cerebral cortex and the prefrontal cortex, the area behind the forehead. This is the area associated with planning and problem-solving related tasks. As it develops, the prefrontal cortex communicates more effectively with other parts of the brain. So you can kind of imagine that any activity that affects the cerebral and prefrontal cortex could seriously affect the individual's development as well. Things like excessive internet usage. One European-based study found that 9 in 10 adults go online in any location, more than doubling the number of hours spent online each week in the last decade, from 10 hours to more than 20. So is it possible, as some scientists have suggested, that the increase in social networking site usage is negatively affecting how we relate to others emotionally and gain a sense of personal identity in the critical phase of neural development? No. At least not according to scientists at the University College London and the University of Oxford, who say that there is no evidence from neuroscience studies to show that typical internet usage harms the adolescent brain. If anything, it's actually useful. Rather than hamper social interaction, adolescents' use of social networking sites has been found to enhance the overall quality of friendships and relationships. The team also found that people generally portray their lives accurately, making online interaction closer to in-person connections. Moving beyond the social side, the same research team found that computer games don't necessarily lead to impulsiveness, a shorter attention span, or aggression. And as for the idea that easy access to search engines breeds superficial mental processing rather than deep knowledge and understanding, the researchers say that it's impossible to blame technology alone for the change in thought process. A lot of things can contribute to the way a person thinks. But this isn't to say that spending all your time online is a good thing. There are still negative effects, though it's an indirect correlation. It's not technology affecting children's capacities, it's the fact that using technology is displacing other activities that are equally important for development. And these are pretty easy correlations to see. Low levels of physical activity associated with sitting around on the internet have been linked to obesity and diabetes, and it's the time spent playing video games rather than doing homework that's responsible for dropping grades among teenage gamers, not the games themselves. So it's not all bad. Like pretty much everything, we just need to make sure we have a good balance in our lives, especially those among us whose brains are still developing. But are your online friends your real friends? Julia took a look at the science behind this one.
One New York Times article claimed that shared experience is the basis of good friendships, but science shows that sharing personal information creates strong social ties.
How much time do you guys spend online every day? And do you feel closer to your friends for all that time spent snooping on their Facebook pictures? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe for more DNews every day of the week.